coming up, we've got the first of two semi-finals in the men's 1500 metres. And one man who is added to the lineup is someone who took an unceremonious fall, Mehdi Bala, the Frenchman. You can just see him tumble there, 100 metres ahead of the finish line. The Olympic bronze medalist, two times a European champion, reinstated and takes his place here in this semi-final. So, Gebre Medin, very, very fast operator. He goes for Ethiopia. Eguida of Morocco is also pretty handy. Ryan Gregson in this one for Australia. And then two names we're very interested in. Silas Kiplagat, the Commonwealth champion from Kenya, the fastest man in the world this year. And then Yusuf Kamal, who is the defending champion, but not in form this year. This is Alimeu, second in the Ethiopian Championships last year. Ryan Gregson also in this one. There he is, the Australian. Mehdi Bala reinstated. There's Silas Kiplagat. He is such a talent. He was waving to the crowd at the Kenyan National Championships. He ran 3:31 at altitude, which is outrageous. And there's Kamal, the defending champion, formerly known as Gregory Conchella, son of two-time world 800-metre champion Billy Conchella, before he switched nationalities to represent Bahrain. Ewan Thomas, your thoughts ahead of this one? Two men with contrasting seasons so far.
Certainly are. We say the reigning world champion, he's 10 seconds this season slower than he has been at his best. But I look down the start list and there's five men in this field who have set personal bests this season. So it's going to be competitive.
Yes, it could be a bit of a carve up this in the last 400 or 500 metres. Kiplagat looks so relaxed. First semi-final of the men's 1500 metres, first five to go through by rights. So Matthew Centrowitz on the inside, the US national champion. McClure, the Algerian, on his shoulder, and Silas Kiplagat, the fastest man in the world this year, in second place. And Matt Kamal on the shoulder of his former compatriot. Mehdi Bala, the man who fell and was reinstated for the semi-final, is right at the back, and it's very, very slow, which means it's going to get very, very tactical as they get towards the end. So Matthew Centrowitz, US champion, but doesn't Kiplagat look so easy in second place? This really is, Ewan Thomas, a total stroll.
It seems that way. Coming up to the first lap marker there. Very steady, as you said, three laps to go. Some of these athletes will literally be jogging at the moment. The race won't begin for another lap or so, but when it does, you'll certainly know about it. This will be a fast finish.
Well, I think at this rate, we can safely say there won't be any fastest losers from this heat. So, Centrowitz jogging along. Kiplagat in second place, the fastest man in the world this year. Alemu, the young Ethiopian, only 18 years of age, and he's in the right place here as his compatriot, the more experienced Gebre Medin, now comes up onto the outside. Very long legs, quite tall for an Ethiopian. So the two compatriots from East Africa just talking to each other there. McClure, the Algerian, on the outside, also still there. Centrowitz has been a bit of a sensation this season. His dad was a very handy 5,000 metre runner. He's tucked in on the inside. Bala still at the back. The two Ethiopians at the front, but still, Ewan, it's pretty steady. Nobody being detached from this pretty pedestrian pace.
Someone needs to pick up the pace here, and who will it be? Less than two laps to go now as they go around the top bend there. As you said, it's been very, very slow so far. In fact, the first lap was slower than the 10K runners the other night. So this will be a fast finish. They've got a lot of work left in their legs.
Gebre Medin leads. Semi-finalist 4 years ago. Lalu coming up on the outside. The defending champion wearing the yellow badge there. Kamal, not had a good season. Looks okay. He's talking to people. It's very, very tight there. There'll be a few elbows, and you can see that Centrowitz has got boxed in. Silas Kiplagat also having to just push his way out of trouble. Still, Gebre Medin leading. McClure, the Algerian, he's played a sensible race so far. Ruiz of Spain dropping back and coming very, very wide on the outside. And as they come through to hit the bell, it's going to be a real carver. Silas Kiplagat, the fastest man in the world this year, as Larling, real bumping there. He gave Gebre Medin a real shove in the side, the Moroccan. And Centrovitz now suddenly somehow finds his way out of trouble and back to the front.
That almost seemed like a 4x4 for me there. Elbows flying everywhere. As you said, they hit the bell and all of a sudden everybody's kicked. They've got about 220 metres to go.
Centrovitz on the inside. Silas Kiplagat going backwards. Barla coming wide. Yusuf Kamal, the defending champion, is struggling. Look at Mehdi Barla moving through the field now. Just coming up into fifth or sixth place. So it's Lalu leading, Gebre Medin, Kiplagat coming wide on the outside. Barla trying to find a way through, but he's boxed in. He's going to have to come wide. Centrovitz still hanging on. Centrovitz from Gebre Medin, Kiplagat, Barla. And I don't know, Kamal may well have to wait to see if he goes through as the fastest loser. But good run from the American and very, very composed qualification from Silas Kiplagat.
What a turnaround of fortunes as well for Barla from France. Fell in the heat, as you said, was reinstated, and he ran really well. Coming up to the bell, look at the barging going on at the front there, Rob.
Well, that was so blatant, it was ridiculous. Gebre Medin throws him a glance to say, hang on, we're going to talk about that when it finishes. Centrovitz on the inside, the American. Gebre Medin sandwiched between Lalu, and Lalu, a really, really good 800 metre runner, going backwards. Mehdi Barla looked really, really composed. Remember, he's the guy that fell. And the defending champion has probably gone, because that was a very pedestrian pace. Confirmation then of the qualifiers from that first semi-final in the men's 1500 metres. Good performances from Kiplagat and Barla. No place in the final for the defending champion.